Hello students, we're going to learn about some amazing body facts. The first fact is about sphincter. Sphincters are the ring-shaped muscles that flexes to open or close a biological opening. They help regulate the entrance, circulation and exit of the fluids throughout our body and the digestive tract. One of the sphincter is the cardiac or the lower esophageal sphincter, which keeps acidic or the gastric juices from splashing back up and burning up of the esophagus. And the second one is called as a pyloric sphincter, which does not allow the chyme to come back from the small intestine into the stomach. The next fact is about the eye color. So what color are your eyes? Blue, brown, black or hazel? Do you know what determines your eye color? Eye color has to do something with this thing called as melanin. Yes, it's the same melanin that is responsible for those freckles on your nose. Skin color and hair color. We all humans have different skin color and we all have different hair color as well. And this skin color and hair color is determined by the same pigment called as melanin. Amongst all the eye colors, blue color is a rare and represents 8% of the world's population and contains the least amount of melanin. Your skin cells keeps dividing. They die and give birth to new cells all the time. Even when you are not injured, yet nerve cells in your brain, also called as neurons, do not renew themselves. So, once they die, they are not replaced. Pineal gland. Pineal gland was given its name because it has pine cone-like shape. Unlike most brain structures, pineal gland is unpaired, meaning there is only one. The function most linked to the pineal gland is a secretion of melatonin, which is best known for its role in regulating circadian rhythm. Do you know what it is? It's a natural internal process that regulates the sleep-wake cycles. Pineal gland consists of secretory cells which secretes melatonin. Its secretion is highest in the middle of the night. It begins to decrease as it gets closer to the dawn and lowest during the day hours. So, melatonin levels indicates or signals to provide information about the time of the day. Gas or flatulence or passing gas is normal daily phenomena. Most individuals, yes, that includes you also, will make anywhere about 500 to 1500 ml of gas and pass gas 10 to 20 times a day. But from where does it come from? A small proportion may come from ingesting the air during sleep or any other times, but majority of the gas is produced by the bacteria in our intestines. As they digest the food which we can't, these bacteria ferment the undigested food to produce gases, that is hydrogen and carbon dioxide, and are most common gaseous products. Some people may produce methane gas too, but methane is odorless. Well, then what stinks? The foul smell is due to volatile sulfur compounds. Human tooth externally can be classified as crown, neck and root, and internally it has three parts: enamel, dentine and pulp. Human brain is split into left and the right side. This structure has inspired one of the most pervasive ideas about the brain, that the left side controls the logic and the right side creativity. It's true that brain has left and a right side. There are many theories, myths and facts related to the brain. One of them is that the brain's right side controls the motion of the left arm and the leg and vice versa, right? And the left side controls the motion of the right arm and leg, so on. The theory that supports it is that related to the development of the nervous system, because it gave the survival advantage of the quicker reflexes. If we see a danger coming from the left side, we escape to our right side, right? We don't move towards the danger, instead we move away from the danger. This proves that right side of the brain controls the left parts of the body and the left side of the brain controls the right side of the body. Smell. Do you know, as an adult, you can distinguish between 10,000 different smells? And here's how your nose does it. Smell starts when you sniff the molecules from the air into your nostrils. Inside the nostrils, you have mucus and the hair to filter the air. At the back side, there is a region called as the olfactory epithelium. The olfactory epithelium has olfactory bulb, which has olfactory receptor cells or olfactory neurons, a special neuron that can smell. When odor molecules hit the back of your nose, they bind to the olfactory receptor cells and send the signals to your brain in the olfactory cortex. It is a part of your forebrain to receive input from olfactory bulb. One speciality about the olfactory neurons is that they are the only neurons in the body that get replaced regularly, right? So the part of your brain that processes the smell is the olfactory cortex. Human skeleton. Human skeleton has 206 bones. It gives support and framework. One of the bones in the skeleton is the humerus located in the upper arm. This is the same bone that's often referred to as the funny bone. That's because the ulnar nerve curves around the elbow end of the humerus and is susceptible to getting knocked, causing a funny tingling sensation down the forearm. I hope you have understood all the facts of your textbook. Now, note down these points from the chapter Know Your Body.